So today we are going to learn what are constructors and destructors in object-oriented programming language, right? So we are doing object-oriented programming language. You all are aware of the terminologies used. We have studied about classes, we have studied about objects, we have studied about the private and public keywords, right? We know what is encapsulation, we know what is data hiding, right? And since you have hidden the data, you have made the data private, so there are certain things which you want to be done automatically. For example, I want all the data members of the class to be initialized with some valid initial value. How will you do that? I do not want to accept value from the user. What I want is, as soon as I create object, like you used to do in procedural programming language, and it was told to you that whenever you declare a variable, if you are declaring an integer variable, you have to initialize the variables with some initial value. And what is that initial value in integers? Zero. Why do you initialize them with the initial values? To remove the garbage value, so that you get the correct output. There are certain cases when you are writing program, you are not initializing the variable, so what you are doing is, you are not getting correct answer, even if you are applying the correct formula, even if you are following the correct methodology, right? So what is this, that error occurred, the wrong output that you are getting is because of the garbage value. So what you do is, you initialize all the variables. This was told to you, right, when you were doing procedural programming language. Same thing I want in object-oriented programming also. What I want is, as soon as the object of that class is created, I want the data members to be initialized by some valid initial values, right? So how do we do that? We cannot access the private members of the class outside. I cannot assign value in the main function. So for that, I need a function which will initialize the data members with the initial value, and that is mandatory to be called whenever the object is created. You want this to be done as soon as the object is created. So object-oriented programming is giving you a feature, a special function, constructor, and there is another function, destructor. So as the name says, that constructor constructs something, and what is that something? The object. Object is created with the help of constructors. So you can also define constructors in your code. What is the use of constructor? Why do we define them? How do we define them? This is what we are going to learn today. Right? So let us start. Constructors. I told you that constructors are used to initialize the data members or construct the object. Right? Now please keep writing this point in your registers. Constructor is a special member function whose task is to initialize the objects of its class. Right? When you create the object, constructor is called automatically, implicitly. Okay, there is nothing automatically in programming. It is implicitly. So it is called implicitly, that is why it's a special function. And what is this task? To initialize the object of the class. Right? It is special because its name is same as the name of the class. This is very important point, that when you are defining a constructor, the name of the constructor should be same as the name of the class. Clear this? Any confusion in this point? The constructor is invoked whenever the object, an object of its associated class is created. So it is invoked implicitly. You need not call it explicitly. I hope you know the difference between implicit call and explicit call. You have done in class 11th also. Right? So explicit call is when we are calling with the help of some object. Now here you do not call the constructor, that is called automatically when you create the class. So that automatically is implicitly. It is called implicitly by the compiler. Okay, that is why it's a special function. it is called constructor because it constructs the values of data members of the class. So I hope it is very clear to all of you what is the role of constructor, why do we use constructor, and why is it special function? What makes it special? The name. You can add one more point to this, that constructors do not return any values. Constructors do not have any return type. So fifth point you can write, constructors do not return any values. Clear this? Shall we move on to the next slide? So there is no need to invoke, there is no need to write any statement to invoke the constructor function. This is what I told you. You need not write any statement to invoke it. It is invoked automatically, implicitly by the compiler. Okay? Now constructor is a special member function whose task is to initialize. Okay. The next is, if a normal member function is defined for zero initialization, we will need to invoke this function for each object separately. Constructor that accepts no parameter. Now this is very important. Now if I want to initialize all the members with initial values, suppose if I have integer values, I want them to be assigned with the value 0. Suppose it is float, so I want to assign 0.0. If it is string, then simple quotes, space. So that is set value, right? So if you are writing a constructor which does not has any parameter, constructor is a function, and if that function does not has any parameter, then that constructor will be known as default constructors. There are different types of constructor. This is one of them, default constructor. What is default constructor? A constructor with no parameter. We can have multiple constructors in a class, right? Do you know the concept of overloading? We can overload a function. Function overloading you have done in class 11. What is function overloading? Giving same name to different functions with different parameters, right? So I can also create different constructors of my requirement, of the requirement of the user, right, with the same name as the name of the class but different parameters. So any constructor having no parameter is known as default constructor. So for example, there is a class A, and for this class a constructor has been defined which is not accepting any parameter. So this is an example of default constructor. I will show you how to write default constructor for your code. Okay? Now before I show you the coding part, just go through the characteristics of constructor. They should be declared in public section. Okay? The constructor, it is important for a constructor to be the public member. I will show you the reason. Why it is public, why not private? You can declare a constructor in private section, but when you try to create an instance of that class, that will not be created. So I will show you the error, right? So please keep this in mind that it should be in public section, constructors. They are invoked automatically when the objects are created, and they do not have any return type. I think I have already given you this point. They do not any return point, return value, not even void. So you do not write any return type when you are defining a constructor. You just write the name of the constructor, which will be the same as the name of the class for which you are defining. Now, before going through these points, I would like to show you the code. I think I was demonstrating this code in the previous class. I hope you understood this code. All of you understood this code? I wrote this code for student class, right? Where I had these data members, roll number and name. So what you want is, as soon as I create the object of student, as soon as I create the object of student, the data member student It is not coming. Okay. Was it visible? So this is the class student which has roll number and name, right? So what I want is, as soon as I create the objects student, the data member roll number should be initialized with the initial value 0 and name should be initialized with space. Okay, so main kya karungi? I cannot do this. I told you that this is not possible. Assigning value to a private variable is not possible here. Okay. I made changes in this code. Now in the public section, I will define the constructor. Now how do you define the constructor? I think you remember the rules. The name of the constructor will be same as the name of the class. So in this case, what is the name of the class? It is student. So what will be the name of the constructor? Student. So I will write student in the same case. Even though it is a function, I have not written any data type. I think you read this point in the slides that constructors do not have any return type, not even void. That is why it's a special function. It has been made special, right? So that it is called implicitly as soon as you create the object. So, what I want is, I want to assign value 0 to this roll number or name ko. I cannot assign space to name like this. How do we assign value to a string? With the help of strcpy function. Isn't it? Remember this? I think you did this in class 11, strings. So if you have to assign any value to string, you will have to use this function. Initializing a string requires this function to be called. strcpy will copy the value into name variable. Is this clear to all of you? Now this is a constructor which is defined. Now I would write a statement here so that you know that the constructor was, how will you know that the constructor was called? So I have written the statement constructor called. Clear this? So that you know that the constructor, where the constructor was called. You will understand that the constructor was called implicitly because this message will be displayed on the screen. Right? Clear this? Now as soon as you create the, I'm not calling any function. I have written getCH. I have just created the object S. I have not called the function get also. Neither I have called show. I have just created the object of the class student. So according to the definition, the constructor will be invoked automatically, implicitly, as soon as the object is created. So we'll see this if it is called implicitly. I'll open the file again. The name of file was demo.cpp. This is the file. Let me compile this. strcpy should have a prototype. What is this error for? Because I have not included the file string.h. Yes. So I will have to include the file string.h, and also the name was misspelled here. So I have corrected the name and I am including the file. Why? Because strcpy function is defined in this file. So to use that function, we have to include the file. Is it correct? Now again, I will compile the code and see if I am getting any errors. The code is compiled without any errors. It is compiled successfully. So I will execute this code and see the output. I did not do anything. What is the output that you are getting? if I put a function clear screen. So it is displaying constructor call. Did I call the constructor? Did I call it with the name? No. I just created the object. पहले भी तो हम कर रहे थे. तो पहले क्या होता था? पहले क्या होता था कि जब आप constructor नहीं बनाते हो class में, तो default constructor automatically compiler generates the default constructor and it is called automatically. So this type, this constructor, this is a constructor which is not having any parameter. Is it having any parameter? No. It is not taking any parameter. So this is a default constructor. Is this very clear to all of you? The use of constructor, why do we require them? You, if you want to initialize the data members of the class with some valid values at the time of creation of the class, construction of the object, then you define the constructors. Now suppose if I want to create another class, let's say S2, and I have a set value, I have a constant value for this. Let's say this is what I have. I do not want to accept value from the user. I want to assign roll number 1 to Pedro. Right? Now, do I have any constructor which is accepting two values, integer? No, we do not have. That means I will have to, now, ye jo kaam hona hai, wo kab hona hai? When the object is being created. So, you will send this value to the function which is constructing this object, and that function is constructor. That means you will have to send these values to the constructor. So there will be another constructor which will accept two values, integer and string. Let us define that constructor also. So I have two constructors in this class. One is which is not accepting any parameter, and second which is accepting two parameters. ठीक है, A has to be assigned to roll number. ये तो करना था मुझे. A में value कौन सी आ रही है जो one मैंने भेजी. One will be assigned to roll number, right? And then name में क्या भेजना है हमें? The value जो P में आ रही है. This is how we do. You remember this? Passing a string into a function. This is how we do. By reference, pointer liya hai maine. I think I have explained this. We have done this in class 11th also. How to pass a string into a function. Is this clear? The code is clear to all of you. Now let us execute. Now how will you see that it has assigned the value? By calling the function showData. I'm not calling the function accept. I am just calling the function show data with the object S2. So S2 mein kya assign ho gaya hoga? Jo maine value di hai. Theek hai, maine get data function nahi call kiya hai. I have assigned the value with the help of a constructor. Right? Let us see. Can you see this? Constructor called. पहले वाला जो कंस्ट्रक्टर था, डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर, उसमें स्टेटमेंट लिखा था मैंने कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल. सो दैट मींस डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर इज आल्सो कॉल्ड. कहां कॉल हुआ था? व्हेन वी आर क्रिएटिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट एस व्हिच इज नॉट एक्सेप्टिंग एनी वैल्यू. ठीक है, तो व्हेन वी आर क्रिएटिंग वैल्यू एन ऑब्जेक्ट विदाउट पासिंग एनी वैल्यू, देन डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर विल बी कॉल्ड. एंड व्हेन यू आर क्रिएटिंग द सेकेंड ऑब्जेक्ट S2, you are passing two values. So the second function was called and the names were, name and roll number were assigned. Is this very clear to all of you? Now I have two constructors here. One constructor which is accepting, which is not having any parameter. So this is default constructor. And second one is having two parameters. So this type of constructor which has parameters in it, which accepts parameter, are known as parameterized constructor. Is this clear? So you can have multiple parameterized constructor in a class. Okay? And the rules for overloading will, this process of having two constructors, more than one constructor in a class. This process, the this process is known as constructor overloading. Oops ke formula, if I talk in terms of oops, this process is constructor overloading. Having more than one constructor in the class but with different parameters. So when you are creating object, depending upon the input you are giving, the constructors are being invoked. Here I have not passed any value, so this is invoking the default constructor while this is invoking the second parameterized constructor. Is this clear to all of you? Any confusion to anyone? So please keep this in mind that when you are declaring a constructor, you're not writing any return type. If you write a return type, that will make it a normal function. That will not be treated as a constructor. Is this clear? So this is the characteristics of constructor, that they do not return any value, not even void. Clear this? And the name should be the same as the name of the class. Any confusion to anyone? So we have done constructors today, and destructors we'll do in the next class. Right? Thank you.